So I'm here with McKabe Cottrell. He's a member of the Spokane Community College baseball team. And McKabe, right off the bat, you're here at the NWAC tournament. You know, Spokane was here last year. You guys are, you know, you have a chance to go even farther this year. What things are you hoping to kind of experience? What things are you hoping to accomplish this year?
Well, obviously we want to go in and kind of set the tone in the first game. You know, we're a competitive team. We expect a lot out of each other, and you know, our coaches expect out of a lot out of us. And so, obviously the end goal is to bring home the title, but we're going to take it one game at a time and show up and do what we can control every day. So.
And then you are part of the Spokane team. What is it about Spokane's program that kind of drew you here and really kind of really was your decision-making factor for being this team?
Well, the coaching staff is awesome here. Seth Heckel, pitching coach and strength coach, has been really helpful for me and kind of some rehab stuff that I've been doing and getting back to kind of where I was in high school and that kind of stuff. And obviously from Spokane, staying home, being able to play with some of the guys I grew up playing with, and it's kind of a fun family atmosphere here.
No, you mentioned high school. So, I mean, playing from high school and even summer league teams, it's a lot different playing at college. You know, everything's just different. Guys are bigger, faster, stronger. What things did you have to learn? What things did you have to adjust to when you made that transition from high school to college?
Pace of play, for sure, and kind of knowing that you can't go out there and just get by on talent. You know, you have to definitely put in the work and compete every single time you're out there on the field, so.
And then, you know, a lot of players, as they're growing up, they'll look at certain, you know, professional athletes or certain teams, and they'll kind of mimic them or even just kind of draw from their attitude, that type of thing. Is there a player that you looked at and said, you know, I kind of like how they approach the game, what their attitude's like, or is there just a team that you followed?
I'm a big fan of Seattle Mariners, you know, just being from Washington, got to support the home team, and you know, back in Felix Hernandez was in his prime. He was a guy I looked up to for sure, and his mentality and the way he competed on the mound was awesome.
Yeah, definitely a guy who, once he got in the zone, it was hard to get him out of that. So, and then, you know, also growing up, you know, for players, you know, you don't make it to the college level just by accident. You know, you may have talent, but it takes someone to motivate you and to really push you to be your best. Who in your life have you seen as your motivator and your inspiration to do better?
My dad, for sure. You know, he's never been a guy to jump on me and, you know, say you got to do this, you got to do that. But he's been in my corner every step of the way and pushes me to be my best. And so he's been huge. And also my high school coach, Chad Ripke, he's been tremendous in my development as a player. And so I look up to them both a lot.
And for you being a starting pitcher, you know, pitchers, especially starters, had to be in that routine. They have a certain time when they start getting warmed up. For you, is there even a level of superstition that you have, or is it really just a routine that you just go at when it's your turn to start?
You know, I've finally gotten a routine this year. Seth Heckel, Coach Heckel, has been huge in helping me find that routine. Until this year, I never really had one, but through some trial and error, we found out a routine that I can go out and perform about 30 minutes before game time, and gets me right in the mood and sets a tone for me. So.
Awesome. And then last question I have for you, you know, you have a lot of young kids who always come out and watch the games, that type of stuff. What advice would you have for them as they're hoping and dreaming to play, you know, at the college level?
Just work hard, you know, enjoy the game. Don't stress the small stuff. Baseball's a game of failure, and if you dwell on failure, then you're not going to have success. So that would be my advice for them.
Well, Kim McKabe, thank you very much and good luck.
Yeah, thank you.